Sinn und der Sinn.
Happy Friday, guys. What's happening? I'm Travis.
And I'm Trevor.
This is Shinobi. On today's video, we are going to make a Nuka-Cola Quantum-inspired guitar. It's going to be awesome. We love that dye. What would you call it? Fluorescent blue color.
Yeah,
sky blue for fluorescent blue. You know, the stuff they make on Breaking Bad.
Yeah, how many bottles did you have to collect on there? Like Fallout 3, what was it, like 4,000 bottles of Nuka-Cola Quantum to complete that mission?
I never completed it, so I don't know.
I don't think I
completed
it either.
Yeah, it was kind of ridiculous.
It was one of them glowing things.
Yeah, I'm not even trying to get no more Nern Root missions up in there.
But, yeah.
Yeah, other than that, we're trying to keep it short today to shorten the length of the videos.
Yep.
Because they're getting kind of long and we'd like to shorten them up a little bit.
Yep.
I already said that again. Short.
But anyways, let's get to the build.
Well, that was the first time using that brand new router.
You know what? Could have been worse.
All right, guys, off camera, I widened this part up a little bit and added this little mouthpiece for the press rod adjustment. And flush, baby.
Yeah, it's time to get to routing.
Excuse me, social distancing from the dust. Well, after that war of attrition, I could plainly say that I don't really like that hand plane. I ended up busting down with the grinder, bam, and then finishing off with a hand plane, or the power plane, I should say. Obviously, there's gonna be a router plane in our future. Learned our lesson. So Nuka-Cola Quantum was introduced in Fallout 3. What was your favorite part about Fallout 3? Comment down below. My personal favorite was the dart gun. I remember crippling those death claws and feeling like a god. But right now, everyone, on this Nuka-Cola Quantum guitar, I set up a little farm right here. I got it all leveled out and all that because my workbench is far from level.
What are you you're doing.
You want your shelf level or not?
And if I say yes, you're gonna provide that for me with that?
Yes, see the bubble?
I'm familiar with the bubble, Morty. I also dabble in precision, and if you think you can even approach it with your sad naked caveman eyeball and a bubble of f***ing air, you're the reason this species is a failure, and it makes me angry.
You're drunk.
You wanna put up a shelf, put up a shelf. You wanna experience true level? Do you?
Yes.
And I'm going to go ahead and pour some resin, and that's what's going to cover my lights for the guitar itself. So hopefully it comes out
totally.
Been a couple days and I just took out the resin and it is extremely brittle. It broke into a bazillion pieces. However, I think I could use this piece to do what I wanted. So, I think I could sand that down, be real careful with it, and see what we can get. I'm gonna try something a little different I've never done before, but I got my sander figured out, and then I marked 10 mil on each side, and I'm hoping that gives me a little more accuracy when I get my spots for my frets, so we'll see what happens. Guys, we're gonna go ahead and glue some wings on so my template works out right nicely. So let's do that. All right, so where we're at on this guitar body so far is I just took care of the round over on the guitar. I'm not gonna do a major carve job. Usually there's a carve top. I'm not gonna do that this time. I took care of the pockets already, like you've seen. I'm currently doing the light pocket. And all these pockets together, including the light pocket, are gonna help out quite a bit. Not only with a cool light show, hopefully, but it's gonna take a lot of weight away from this guitar because this body by itself without any cavities are about 8 pounds. It's not a light guitar body because it is solid maple. So, that's going to be cool. Anyways, I want to talk to you about deathclaws real quick. Did you know deathclaws were actually made before the war to be alternative troops in the United States military? But after the bombs dropped, they actually escaped and became the apex predator you know and hate today. So I went in with the razor to break up the grain a little bit to make it a little easier when I cut my fret slots. So hopefully that works out a little better for me.
I do gotta say, that went pretty good. I'm always a little iffy on cutting the fret slots by hand. It's pretty scary for me, because I'm, you know, still pretty new at it and stuff. But it went pretty good, so on to the radius.
Barbara, give me one style shinobi. Thank you.
Is that what that thing's for? Hello?
One style shinobi? I got a proposition for ya. I'm gonna need the best, the bluest, the greatest guitar of all time.
Yeah.
I need it slapped together, I need it Genin style. I need it now.
Okay, but yeah, but can we
I need blue, and I want it from you.
Why are you talking like that?
Okay, this is what I'm thinking. I'm doing a Nuka-Cola Quantum. It's our newest brand, our newest selling point of all time. And it's gonna be great. It's gonna be Topps Bluebee. I'm telling you. Bring it to me as soon as possible. Thank you and bye.
I don't think I caught any of that. Probably because of the headphones. Whatever. Let's get to work. Nice.
Where the hell is he? It's been 30 seconds. Devin, get him in here.
What
Perfect
the hell?
Timing.
That was weird.
You took long enough.
Here's the thing for you.
It looks good. It looks good, kid.
Tight.
You know what? This calls for celebration. Let's have a drink. Devin! Whiskey. Screwball Whiskey. Not a sponsor. Accepting sponsorships. All right, guys. There you have it. Nuka-Cola Quantum. It was a great build, not gonna lie.
Yeah.
Came out Topps Bluebee, as it were. From head to toe, I was the one that did the neck, so I'll start with that. Got a Nuka-Cola bottle cap on the headstock. Blue and turquoise dye. Going down the neck, 24 frets, 25 and a half inch scale. I did a Nuka-Cola inlay.
And it looks great. Yeah. It's very nice. I think it looks fantastic.
Yeah. I did it with blue and purple resin, mixed it up pretty good. And, you know, I think it came out pretty good. Onto the body.
And the body, of course, we'll get to the lights in a little bit, but I did the lights backwards on this. So they turn on and off with the switch. They turn off when I press the button because I'm stupid and don't know how to wire anything. Mm. But besides that, it came out pretty good. This is all resin and is super thin and brittle. We used a nice quilted maple body for the whole thing. And you can see the striations when it's up close and personal. Mm-hmm. We used a blue to purple burst. And let's see, I used a true oil finish. We used resin knobs with the classic Nuka-Cola caps on the top. I also inlaid a Nuka-Cola cap where the end jack was. And altogether, I think it's a really nice guitar, honestly.
Yep.
You know, plays real well. We'll go ahead and get to the play after this.
Yep. And as always, we rate our guitars. Genning, tuning, joning, and kage. So I think it's a unanimous decision. Genning.
It's pretty close to tuning, not gonna lie.
Yeah.
But it's Genning. It's Genning.
Yeah. It was running through the forest and then got wrecked by Gara.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, Gara pretty much wrecked anybody. I mean, to be fair, he was wrecking tuning and
Except Rock Lee. Rock Lee gave it to him.
Come on, you really think you'll be able to get through Gara's defenses just by dropping a couple of pounds of weight?
Gave him the goods.
Dude, Rock Lee, my dude. Dude,
we're supposed to be talking about Fallout. Fallout's a really fun video game. You should try it out.
Check it out. You know, we collected a lot of Nuka-Cola for this build, so please like, comment, share. Share us on Twitter, Facebook. What's another one? Instagram. That's one, I think.
Yep.
But yeah, please subscribe if you get a chance. Anyways, this is the Woodstyle Shinobi checking out. Later!
West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing.